Hello, Klaus here. Here is a super quick update video to the camera update 8.6, which were out last week for the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera. And in that update, there were some talk about improved gyro stabilization, and that's what we're going to test now. What is the difference between the old firmware and the new firmware? So here we are at a clip, and I tried to shoot these so they kind of matched up together. So let's just figure this out. So here we have the shot on the old firmware with no gyro at all. And as you see, that is quite shaky. And this is shot on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. So let's just try to use the gyro. So I'm going to select the clip and I'll go here up in the inspector, and on the stabilization, I'll change this to camera gyro, and I'm just going to stabilize that. So per default, we are going to see that it is going to crop in our image. However, it does help a little with the shakiness, I do believe. It isn't a gimbal shot, but it's usable like this. I'm going to go now here with the new firmware, and here we have the same shot more or less. Again, pretty shaky. So let's see if the stabilization can do something. Let's go into the camera gyro and stabilize that shot. Like that, and let's have a look at that. You saw how bumpy it was, so let's have a look here. Again, it helps a bit. And I also, again, did this a close-up shot here on the old firmware update. This is shot on my favorite lens, the Helios 44, which I like to use. So here we have the shot, and that is super shaky because it's a 58mm lens trying to do like a walking behind the shoulder shot. So let's just take the old firmware update here, and let's try to do the stabilization once again on this. There we go. So let's see here. I think this does a pretty good job at making it stable. So let's just jump to the new firmware here. I can have a look at the clip again. Pretty shaky. And let's just try to stabilize that. Going on. And again, that's a pretty stable shot. However, you know, when using the gyro stabilization, you do need to shoot wider than you think because of the crop or the zoom that will be in the shot. So I'm just going, you can see here what it does. I'm just going to take off the zoom here so you can actually see how much it actually moves around, which is crazy. So it's doing a pretty good job. And we can also go on the old firmware and we can take off the zoom here and we can see how it moves around like that. So it does a pretty good job at trying to keep your shot stable. However, again, remember to shoot wider than you think, try to be more steady and stuff like that. If there is a huge improvement in the gyro data, I can't really tell, but at least there is a little test about that. So what do you think? Do you think the gyro stabilization is better in the new firmware or the old firmware? Let me know down in the comments below. I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.